What's going on, guys? My name is Mark Wagner, and today I'm going to be showing you how you should structure your ad copy to make as many sales as possible. People don't think this is as big of a deal as it really is, but trust me, you gotta watch this video. Alright, so this video is going to be split up into two parts, Instagram influencers and Facebook ads. These are kind of similar as far as ad copy goes, but they're definitely not the same. We're going to be starting with Instagram influencers. Alright, so the way I structure my ad copy on influencers is usually something like this. The attention grabber is usually a sale notification saying something like Black Friday sale, anniversary sale, insane cheap, whatever. I usually do this in all caps. You're going to want to keep the attention grabber fairly short so it fits on the same line as the influencer's username, like so. Next, you're going to want to put an emoji next to the sale announcement. This may be something niche specific to draw people's eyes. Next, you're going to want to talk about the sale. Say this ad is giving out this product for this percentage off for this amount of time. Put the off in all caps so that you can draw attention to how much it's on sale. I highly recommend discounting products by 60% or higher, even if that means just bumping up your compare ad price. Then follow that by two emojis and then something that provokes their sense of scarcity. Whether it's limited stock available or once they're gone, don't miss out, whatever. It's all up to you to test, but you need to have this. Then you want to put one or two ads to your page and you're done. The big key with influencer ads is that you keep them short, sweet, and eye-catching. Use 2 to 3 emojis and don't ramble on about your product. Instead, intrigue people about your product so that they visit your website and who knows, they might just end up buying. Some other things you want to consider when making your ad copy is that there's different objectives. I just explained a 100% direct sales-based objective, but there's also value in stating stuff like tag someone who'd like this or telling people to follow your account. In addition, I tend to go for a less salesy approach depending on the kind of product that I'm selling. Sometimes I like to approach it from the influencer's perspective. For example, this is so cute. My friends at this username are giving them out X percentage off today only. Tell them that I sent you, smiley face, whatever. That stuff works wonders if you do it right because you're taking advantage of the connection that the influencer has built with their audience. That's the approach that you want to take for personal brands, and it can also be the approach that you want to take for certain other accounts and products. Alright, now let's move on to Facebook. On Facebook, I always start out with a catchy headline, but not like a sales notification like with influencers. On Facebook, the first line needs to show them that you're going to solve this problem or do whatever the product's purpose is. Something like, show your girlfriend they mean the world to you with our X product. Then say something like, now 60% off or now 60% off for Black Friday. The next line you need to tell your customers how to buy. Say, click shop now, and if they're on Facebook, you can say, or click this link. The next line is reassurance or scarcity. Limited stock available, don't miss out, whatever.
I really hope you guys took some value out of this video. Trust me when I say that your ad copy is going to make a huge difference in your sales, so take the time to test it before you really start scaling a product. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.